I'm sure even people who don't follow football have heard by now.
John Gruden gone as head coach of the Las Vegas Raiders, resigning after a New York Times report about homophobic, misogynistic, and racist emails that he sent over the course of 7 years.
The old trifecta. But I have to be honest about this. What did we think his emails were like? I mean, the guy was making these jokes on television.
You're like my wife when you get in space. You just get lost.
What? Gruden to me has just always had that vibe of like the neighborhood dad who takes it one joke too far at barbecues. You're back for your first spring break from college and he kind of leans in and he's like, so that girlfriend of yours, bet she knows how to suck a mean dick, huh? And you're like, what the fuck, John? You know, your father and I once had a threesome with a greyhound. Okay. Now, you do have most players and analysts saying this has no place in the game, while most owners and executives are trying to jam MacBook Pros into a paper shredder. And I really do think the real story here is probably going to be watching the NFL's power structures integrate with modern society the same way the Columbia space shuttle integrated with our atmosphere. But we do have some classic culture war shit going on, because a bunch of people took this as an opportunity to be like, fuck cancel culture. And a lot of other people were like, this is clear white supremacy. Now, personally, I think taking private emails he sent to a longtime friend and coworker as a complete expression of who he is a bit much. But so is the idea that having expressed those opinions, he should still get to be the face of a multi-billion dollar organization that represents a lot of the exact people he just pissed off just because fuck cancel culture. If you believe in free markets, everyone with this profile picture, that is how they work. Also, if your argument is like, but players commit crimes too, every situation is different. That's not what we're talking about. And even if we were, for the love of God, do not make this your first example.
Okay, here are just a few of the people who are currently playing in the NFL and their alleged crimes, like actual criminal activity, not bad old emails. Bradley Chubb, who's injured for the Denver Broncos. He failed to appear for a court date on misdemeanor traffic charges near Denver.
But I understand why people think it's hypocritical. If you leaked some conversations for me that I had with a friend privately 10 years ago, I might have also called Roger Goodell an anti-football Obviously, I'm kidding. He said some wild shit that can't be defended. But be honest, are there no situations where you're having a private conversation with a friend and you say some shit that you know is crossing the line just to do it? Context and the sanctity of private conversation means a lot to me as a person, as a comedian, as a drinker. So it sucks. The only time it seems like people defend privacy is when you're already in trouble and you've got too much else going on. So I do want to take time to defend it here before I get in trouble for something else later on. It is truly crazy. This all came out of an investigation that wasn't even about John. It was about the Washington football team, whose mascot and name will in 10 years sound just as ridiculous as probably some of the shit that he said. But it wasn't just a couple jokes. He spent a decade going, fuck drafting queers, lady refs this, something about a black guy's lips. I mean, John. He found a way to offend both people who loved and hated Chappelle's special. So it showed us a lot about how he talked to some of the other important decision makers at work at one of the most powerful organizations in the country that makes decisions about the lives of a lot of the people that he was denigrating. His problem isn't just a bunch of out-of-context private conversations. His problem is a lot of people around the league think those conversations are showing us who he really is.
Talking behind people's back.
Yeah.
That was one of his traits in Tampa. Everything, Stephen A., I love you. I love you, Molly. You're great. But as soon as I go around the corner, I can't stand them you-know-whats and this, that, and the other. I got to get...
So privacy is important. But ultimately, if something comes out that shows you who someone really is, sometimes that's just what it is. But you know what they always say.
They are who we thought they were. And we let them off the hook.